Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Dr. Nimisha Jadhav from School of Studies Environmental Chemistry, Jivaji University, Gwalior. Today we are going to discuss about the module Analysis and Control Methods of SOX, that is oxides of sulfur, under the paper of Environmental Analysis. The learning objective of this module included the sources and their various effects of oxides of sulfur, then their analytical methods of determining SOX in the ambient air, and their control measures. The sulfur dioxide or the oxides of sulfur are the compounds of sulfur and the oxygen molecule. The sulfur dioxide is the predominant form found in the lower atmosphere. It is a colorless gas that can be detected by test. It has a pungent, unpleasant odor. And the sulfur dioxide dissolves readily in the water present in the atmosphere to form the sulfuric acid or the sulfurous acid. About 30% of the sulfur dioxide in the atmosphere is converted to the sulfate aerosols. It can be removed through the wet or the dry deposition processes. The sulfur trioxide is the another oxides of sulfur is either emitted directly into the atmosphere or it is produced from the sulfur dioxide and is rapidly converted to the sulfuric acid. The major sources of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere including the burning of fuels, then roasting metal sulfides, ores, volcanoes, thermal power plants, high sulfur coal or heating oil, industrial boilers and non-ferrous metal smelters, and vehicular exhaust, etc. Here in this picture, the picture shows the various sources of release of oxides of sulfur into the atmosphere. The first picture shows the smelters industries or the smelter are the major source of sulfur into the atmosphere. In the second pictures, here you have seen the volcanic eruption, which is the natural source of oxides of sulfur into the atmosphere. And third one is the showing the stack of the thermal power plant, which are the major source of oxides of sulfur into the atmosphere. Now we are discussing about the health and environmental impacts of sulfur oxide. The sulfur oxides affects the health of human being and causes damage to the vegetation. The concentration of the sulfur oxide is close to the ground level. It reduces the lung function, then it increased incidences of respiratory symptoms. It also causes the irritation of the eyes, nose and the throat, and also causes the premature mortality. Here in this figure you have seen impacts of oxides of sulfur, like it causes nausea, coughing, bronchitis, etc. The health impacts appear to be linked especially to brief exposures to ambient concentrations above 1000 microgram per meter cube. Some studies show that low annual mean levels and excess mortality. It is not clear that whether the long-term effects are related simply to the annual means or not. But the health effects attributed to sulfur oxides are due to the exposure to the sulfur dioxide, sulfate aerosols, and sulfur dioxide absorbs onto particulate matter. Alone, sulfur dioxide will dissolve in the watery fluid of the upper respiratory system and be absorbed into the bloodstream. The sulfur oxide react with other substances in the atmosphere to form sulfate aerosol. Since most sulfate aerosols are part of PM 2.5 and have an important role in the health impacts associated with fine particulates. Now we are going to discuss about the procedure of the analysis of SOX for the monitoring of ambient air quality. The most frequently used method for the SOX in the air is known as modified West and Greek method. It is a method that is also used by the Central Pollution Control Board. So that's why we are discussing here about this method. The sulfur dioxide from the air is absorbed in a solution of potassium tetrachloromercurate, it is also known as TCM, and the dichlorosulfitomercurate complex is formed, which resists the oxidation by the oxygen in the air is formed, and once it is formed, this complex is stable to strong oxidants such as ozone and the oxides of nitrogen. The complex is made to react with the para-rosaline and the formaldehyde to form the intensely colored para-rosaline methyl sulfonic acid as an end product, and the absorbance of this solution is measured by means of a suitable spectrophotometer. The instrument or the equipment used for the analysis including the analytical balance, vacuum pump, calibrated flow measuring device to control the airflow, absorber, spectrophotometer, and various types of glassware. In this picture, you have seen, first picture shows the spectrophotometer, which is used to check the presence of sulfur oxides in the air sample by the absorption method, and here this instruments obey the Lambert-Beer's law, where the absorption of the UV radiation by the complex is directly proportional to the concentration of a substrate present in the sample tube. So by this instrument we can find out the how much of the sulfur oxide present in the air sample. The second picture shows the absorber. This absorber, you have seen the air enter into the chamber, then here is the hot wire or temperature sensor which senses the presence of sulfur oxide, then it is trapped by the some absorbing media. And the third one figure shows the motor or the suction pump, which is used to capture or to suck the air volume in a desired level. The reagents or the chemical used for this purpose including distilled water, mercuric chloride, potassium chloride or the sodium chloride, EDTA disodium salt, absorbing reagent 0.04 molar, potassium tetrachloromercurate, that is TCM. Then sulfuric acid 0.6%, formaldehyde 0.2%, purified para-rosaline stock solution of 0.2% nominal, then para-rosaline working solution concentrated, then the stock iodine solution of 0.1 normality, iodine solution of 0.01 normal, starch indicator, and the potassium iodide. Now we are discuss here about the sampling procedure. For the sampling, first of all, one should place 30 ml of the absorbing solution in an impinger and sample it for 4 hours at a flow rate of 1 liter per minute. After sampling, measures the volume of the sample and transfer to a sample storage bottle. Here in this picture, figure shows that how the sample is by the absorbing solution in impinger. The right one figure shows the sample storage bottle, where when the air enter into the impinger, then they pass out to through the carbon trap, which absorbs some impurities which are also present in the air sample. Then it is transferred to the sample storage bottle, where the sulfur oxide by the absorbing media. Now we discuss here about the procedure of the analysis of SOX in the ambient air. For this, first of all, one should have to place a 30 ml of absorbing media in an sphincter for absorbing the oxides of sulfur in the solution. Then connect it to the gas sampling manifold of gas sampling device. Then draw air at a sampling rate of 0.002 ppm to 5 ppm per minute for 4 hours. Then check the volume of sample at the end of the sampling and record it. Then transfer the exposed sample in storage bottle and preserved for a period of time. Then prepare calibration graph as recommended in the method. Then take 10 or 20 ml aliquot of the sample in a 20 ml of volumetric flask. Then take 20 or 10 ml of unexposed sample in the 25 ml of volumetric flask for the preparation of blank solution. Then add 1 ml of sulfamic acid and keep it for 10 minutes. After the 10 minutes, add 2 ml of formaldehyde and 2 ml of working PRA solution, that is para-rosaline aniline solution. Then make up the solution up to the mark with distilled water, that is 25 ml. Then keep it for 30 minutes for reaction. Then set zero of the spectrophotometer with the distilled water and measure the absorbance of the solution at 560 nanometer. Then calculate the concentration using the calibration graph method. Then calculate the concentration of the sulfur dioxide in microgram per meter cube. The absorbance of the sample as well as the standard series will be subtracted by the absorbance of the blank solution. Now we are coming to the calculation part. Here, calibration curve for the standard solution of concentration of sulfide solution calculated by the formula C is equal to V1 minus V2 into N into K divided by V, where C is the concentration of sulfur dioxide in milligram per ml. Then V1 is the volume of thiosulfate for blank in ml. V2 is the volume of thiosulfate for sample in ml. Then N is the normality of thiosulfate. And V is the volume of standard sulfide solution in ml. K is the correction factor or the dilution factor if required. Now for the sample, the calculation is done by the C, that is the sulfur oxide in microgram per meter cube, is equal to ASAB in bracket into CF into VS divided by VA into VT, where CSO2 is equal to the concentration of nitrogen oxide in microgram per meter cube. AS is the absorbance of the sample. AB is the absorbance of reagent blank. CF is the calibration factor. VA is equal to volume of air sampled in meter cube. VS is equal to volume of sample in ml. And VT is equal to volume of aliquot taken for analysis in ml. Here we are going to discuss about the control measures of reduction of SOX either from the fuel or from the flue gases. The control measures included the extraction of sulfur from the fuel and the sulfur present in either organic and the inorganic form. And in inorganic form, iron sulfide is present, and the inorganic sulfur can be reduced readily by doing the washing. And the organic sulfur present in the form of cysteine, thiose and sulfides, and this is readily removed by various types of chemical processes. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the hydro desulfurization of coal. This process uses a solvent extraction process for the removal of sulfur. The organic and the inorganic both sulfur can be removed by using this procedure. In this process, coal is slurried with anthracene oil and then the slurry is heated at high temperature up to 450 degrees centigrade to dissolve the coal. Then the sulfur is eliminated by using the filtration process. The next control procedure of sulfur oxide is known as coal gasification. This produces better quality gas other than the oxides of sulfur. It removes both organic as well as inorganic oxides of sulfur, and the process is affected with partial oxidation of coal in presence of oxygen and steam. This process yields carbon monoxide and hydrogen. The reaction involved here is C plus H2O is equal to CO plus H2 radical, where a regeneration process is also used called as Gierbüttel process. The next is the desulfurization of fuel oils. The sulfur can be removed from fuel oil by method hydro desulfurization process. In this process, fuel oil treated with hydrogen over a catalyst at temperature higher than 300 degrees centigrade. Estimated cost for reducing sulfur content fuel by 50%. The other important method is fuel oil gasification. The next is the sulfur reduction during combustion. It is applicable to the conventional combustion chamber. Finely ground limestone is injected directly into the combustion chamber. The limestone is calcined to calcium oxide by heat of combustion. It reacts with sulfur oxide containing in the flue gas to form sulfides and sulfates. Here in this reaction, you have seen that the calcium carbonate convert into the CaO plus CO2, that is calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Then this CaO again react with SO2 and result is CaSO3, that is calcium sulfide. And again CaO react with the SO2 and with the half of oxygen is also involved there, and then it is converted into the calcium sulfate. The next is the desulfurization of the flue gases. Desulfurization of the flue gases is done by dry method. It can be classified as adsorption of sulfur dioxide by metal oxides to form stable sulfides and the absorption on the activated carbon. The second process is known as the process using metal oxide. It is classified again into two process. One is alkalized alumina process. It is a cyclic adsorption process. And second one is the manganese oxide process. Here the activated manganese oxide are used as adsorbent. This figure shows the process of desulfurization of flue gases by using calcium carbonate. Here in this figure, there is a closed chamber where the limestone bed is used to absorb the sulfur dioxide present in the flue gas. The flue gas is passed through the limestone bed, then it comes over to the chamber. Then after the absorption of the sulfur at the upper layer of this tank here is the spray tower, which spray through the flue gases so that the particles from the flue gases are settled down at the base of this tank and the clear gas is passes through the top of this cylinder. Now the second one method that we are going to discuss here is the wave scrubber method. It is again of two types. The one is limestone scrubbing and the second one is magnesium oxide scrubbing. For the lime stone scrubbing, the reaction involved is that the calcium carbonate react with the oxides of sulfur in the presence of oxygen and forms the calcium sulfate or the sulfide and release the carbon dioxide of the carbonate ion. The equation is that the CaCO3 plus 2SO3 plus half O2 is equal to CaSO3 plus CaSO4 plus 2CO3. In the second reaction, the calcium hydroxide, that is CaOH whole twice, react with oxide of sulfur, that is SO2 plus half O2, then it will be converted into the CaSO3 plus CaSO4 plus 2H2O. It means the whole sulfur is forms the solid complex with the calcium in the form of sulfite or sulfate. In the another method of scrubbing is the magnesium oxide scrubbing, where the magnesium oxide react with the sulfur dioxide and form the magnesium sulfide, that is MgSO3. And this MgSO3 again react with oxygen and water and convert it into the magnesium bisulfide. And this magnesium bisulfide again react with the magnesium oxide and convert into the magnesium sulfide plus water. And so in the whole process, again the sulfur is bound with the magnesium oxide and removed from the flue gases. Now we discuss here about the wet lime scrubbing. This system use a slurry of lime or the limestone in water to absorb sulfur oxide from the flue gas in a gas liquid scrubber. Waste gases are fed in an ash collector and then moved to a wet scrubber sprayed by a slurry of fine ground limestone or hydrated lime. The sulfur dioxide is absorbed to produce calcium sulfide and calcium sulfate. The reaction we have already discussed in the previous slide. So the figure shows that the scrubbing liquid again converted as a residue or the water fraction is collected separately. In the second figure shows the magnesium oxide scrubbing. The magnesium oxide process developed in the USA by the Chemical Construction Corporation, Chemico, is a regenerative process rather than a throwaway operation like the limestone scrubbing. In the other word, it does not produce waste material and the sulfur dioxide removed from the flue gas is concentrated and used to make marketable H2SO4 or elemental sulfur. In the chemical process, the flue gas is scrubbed with the slurry of magnesium oxide in a Venturi scrubber which absorbs sulfur dioxide and yield magnesium sulfide and sulfate according to the following reaction, that magnesium oxide reacts with sulfur oxide and produces magnesium sulfide. Then this magnesium sulfide again react with sulfur oxide and water and convert into the intermediate unstable compound, that is MgHSO3 whole twice. Then MgHSO3 whole twice is again react with magnesium oxide and convert into the 2MgSO3, that is magnesium sulfide plus water. When this magnesium sulfide get the oxygen, then it convert into the magnesium sulfate. The next control method of sulfur dioxide is known as Wellman-Lord process. This process employs saturated solution of sodium sulfide to absorb sulfur dioxide from flue gases in a scrubber. The sulfide is converted to bisulfide. Here in this reaction, you have seen that the sodium bisulfide is converted into sodium sulfide and sulfur dioxide and water to absorb the sulfur dioxide. The fly ash removal prior to sulfur dioxide scrubbing is necessary to keep the rate of accumulation in the scrubbing liquid low. The sodium sulfide or the bisulfite solution thus formed is fed to a double effect evaporator crystallizer where the bisulfite decomposes into sodium sulfide around 110 degrees centigrade, releasing concentrated sulfur dioxide and steam. The next one method is used for the control of oxides of sulfur is microbial method. In this method, the sulfur deficient bacteria is utilized for the control of oxides of sulfur. The sulfur deficient bacteria is first cultured in medium which contains all the nutrients except the sulfur. And when they are passed through the air containing sulfur, they utilize it for their growth. The example of such bacteria is IGT-57. The next method, including the reducing the sulfur content of the fuel before combustion. The emissions of sulfur oxide are proportional to the sulfur content of the fuel, although with regards to coal, a proportion and usually less than 10% is retained in the ash. Therefore, one of the simplest ways to reduce the amount of sulfur dioxide released from the combustion process can be achieved by switching to a fuel that has a lower sulfur content, that is burning low sulfur coal or gas instead of high sulfur coal. The next method, including the sulfur removal during the combustion process. A number of technologies to prevent the production and the release of sulfur dioxide during the combustion have been developed over the past decades, but very few have achieved a wide commercial application to nowadays. The most developed are the fluidized bed combustion process, that is FBC process, and the integrated gasification combined cycle system. It is denoted as IGCC system. The other methods of control used improve the efficiency of conversion of fuel to electricity, and this would reduce the pollutant emission per unit of electricity generated. Then the shift to the nuclear generation as rapidly as possible, since no sulfur oxide or the particulate is emitted from the nuclear plant, and the shift of the fossil fuel plants to the lower sulfur fuel is the another control measure of removal of oxide of sulfur. The removal of sulfur from the coal before the combustion, or of the sulfur oxide after combustion, but before it enters the stack, the techniques to be considered are coal preparation, that is conventional and advanced technology, solvent refined coal, then low sulfur or low BTU gas from the coal, then fluidized bed combustion, then shift fuel consumption from electricity to pipeline grade gas made from coal or to solar energy. So at the end of this module, we can conclude it that the sulfur dioxide is the predominant form found in the lower atmosphere. It is a colorless gas and can be detected by the test, and its health effects attributed to the sulfur oxides are due to the exposure to sulfur dioxide and sulfate aerosols. Then sulfur dioxide absorbs onto the particulate matter. So these are the main causes of asthmatic and bronchitis diseases in the human being. So here we are discussing about the determination method by the spectroscopic method and their control measures by various dry method and the wet scrubbing method, so that we can eliminate the sulfur either at the end of fuel that we are going to use for the industrial purposes, or if it is not controlled at that level, then we can also control the removal of the SOx sulfur oxide from the flue gases by using various types of method. Thank you so much.